Hi everybody, I'm Kim Fields. Welcome to the Corning live stream. Today we're going to be making an Oriental poppy here. And so without further ado, we're just going to start. I'll be talking a little bit about the components that I made in advance so that we can save a little time and get the piece completed. So to start, you think I do a little research and I like to use reference photos quite a lot, so you get the accuracy of colors. So we're going to start by building that little center pod in the poppy. And doing that, I'm using some pea green. And we're just going to make a very small little wrap. And we're going to even that up. We're going to marver that. Just to make a tiny little barrel. And I'm going to be using a cane today that it's kind of my go-to leaf cane, but I also use it for this pod because I think it's pretty nice. I start with a white core, a Phetre white, and then it's layered with pea green and then an olive color and then transparent sage green. And I like the variegation and the tones that it gives when you use it. It just looks so much more natural. So I'm going around and I'm casing this little tiny little bundle. And we're just going around. And once you get that cased with that cane, now we're going to come around to the back and we're going to hit it in the flame and let those ends of that cane kind of gather to the end. And then we're going to marver. And then I'm going to hit the front, and that's going to pull the tips of those canes down to the center. And then I'm going to even it up. And then for a final, we're just going to get it nice and even. And one more shot in the back. It doesn't matter that the end is a little bit uneven, because we're going to be covering that soon. Okay, so now our little pot is done. Now I'm going to take some Phetre black. And I'm going to run a little lip wrap around the back of that. Times around should do it. And then I'm going to come in from behind. I'm going to let that flame kind of carry that black down onto the mandrel. Get it nice and super juicy. And then I'm just going to marver it. And that's going to taper down even more. So now I have a footprint for the mask that I'm going to be building for the base of the flower itself. So now on that black, I'm going to use a larger rod, which is going to deposit more, but I'm going to be able to do this without, and I have a clean line on the pod. So this gives me an opportunity to build up a pretty big mass behind it. And you want to, these petals are fairly large, so you want to have enough. I usually go to about a little bit larger than the size of a nickel. That should be okay. But it's got to be able to accommodate the six large petals. There's three in the front, three in the back. I hit that behind with the heat just to let that really round up on me while avoiding the front. And I'm going to just start rolling and even it up. Hit in the back a little bit. And we're going to taper that down even more. And you can even up your ends a little bit in the back. Now we're going to put it a little bit in the front. We're going to get that nice and sharp. So now we've got our little pod, and we've got our flower body built. So I'm going to take clear, and we're going to start building our petals. So warm the area that's going to receive the glass and make a little deposit. And have them fairly evenly spaced, so you're looking for three. You know, it can look on end. I'm going to add a little bit more there. And just make sure that's the base of your petal, so you want to make sure that they're fairly well attached to that flower body. Yes, there's three. And then I'm going to warm this. I'm going to lower this down below the flame, and in the flame, I'm going to just deposit another gather of clear, and then I'm going to rotate around and deposit another, and then bring it back to the last one and make another. And so now what you're doing is you're just building up that mass, and we're going to do one more. And that should do it. So now the heating and the retracting back of the petals is kind of a balancing act. So what you want to do is you want to come in and you want to go up and down and up and down in and out of the flame. Switch hands up and down, so that you get a nice even heat deposit there. And with these tweezer mashers, or these stamp tweezers, and just finish. We're going to hang it upside down, let gravity pull that down a bit, and then we're going to squeeze it sideways slightly, hit it again, and then you're going to squeeze, and as you squeeze, you're pushing in slightly, but you start in the center and then you go to the sides. Now we're going to come under that petal that you just squeezed, and you're going to start pulling that up from the sides, which is going to put a natural cup in that petal. And you're going to chill your tool and give it an overall front and back. And now we're going to do the next one. Just do that little sideways squeeze, get sure everything is straight, and then give it a good heat. And then again, just hit the side. Chill your tool. Get rid of all the water. And just let it collapse down. And it's balancing. Now, gravity, when you hold it like this, gravity wants to pull that away from that base. which is why you push in when you squeeze it, so that the termination point of those petals is nice and beefy.
When you say push in, when you squeeze, do you mean like when you're flattening?
Yep. When you're flattening, you're actually kind of also easing it back. Because like I said, it's really hot and gravity wants to pull it away. And you want to push that in. So you want the base of that petal to be fairly wide. Not so wide, but you want a little bit of a taper, but you definitely want to make sure that it's firmly attached. Now for the color, when I do color, it's like a back painting thing. They have these yummy little patches, these black patches. I don't know if you can see that. We're going to put those patches on first. And then we are going to overlay that with carrot red. So the black that I have found that works pretty well is called Rickenbach Deep Black. It doesn't bleed. It stays nice and stiff. If you use a Fetre Black, it has a tendency to wash out and go purple on you. Intense Black bleeds a little. So I just found that it works really well. But less is more in this case. So notice how I just changed my handhold to this so that I have access in the back nice and easily. So I'm going to bring this up underneath a flame and just the tiniest little bit, we're going to make a stroke and make sure that it hits that base flower body. And you can look at it on end and you can see it. What's that?
Where is that dot? In between the petal at the attachment point?
Yes. Yes. So now with the with your brass marver and the radius right here, this rounded radius, you're going to come into the really hot part of the flame and you're going to hit that and you're going to take that radius and you're going to just touch it to chill it. And you're going to come around and you're going to do the next one. And you're going to come around and you're going to do the next one. And that's going to give you a nice firm attachment so that they're not going to retract. And when you're heating this, flowers in general, you want to heat the back and the front. So you have to figure out, you know, how am I going to heat that? You got to get in there and make sure you get all around. Now I'm going to come in here and I'm just going to focus on that little patch, soften that petal and give it a squeeze. I'm going to come to the next one and do the same thing. Yeah, well, these things happen. So I said I was using deep black. Let's try that again. Reset. Preparation is everything. I'm just going to repeat what we did because I picked up the wrong black. Darn it. One of the reasons that I keep flaring these petals up like that is that it's easier, obviously easier access to get to the back to put the color on. So now we're going to take our carrot red. And I'm going to get a fairly healthy gather at the end of that stringer. And I'm going to put one stroke on each, continuing to hit in the front and the back, because you want to make sure that that attachment, when you're adding glass to glass, that attachment is warm. And then right next to it, nice little stroke, again, all the way down to the flower body base. Come into the front, give a little heat. And the touchdown point is just behind the tip of that clear, because you don't want any of the opaque to overlap onto the front. And once you've got all of your petal filled in, now we're going to take that brass marver, and again, using that radius side, I'm going to soften that and come in the really hot part of the flame, but not to the point where it's going to boil. You just want to really get that nice and hot so that that glass fuses together and flows. And now we're going to take our stamp tweezers. And the heating of this is you want to rotate, and you want the heat from the top down, which is going to kind of seal those edges of those petals with that clear, because it's going to retract onto the back. So hit the front, then in the back, and you'll see when it starts to move, then you're going to squeeze real hard in the center, and then side, and side, and just soften. Hit the side. And now what you're looking for is, hopefully you've got a complete fill, but if you've got any kind of halo effect, or you've got any areas that need a little, you know, little touch up, you can do that now, or you can do it later. So we'll just fill a couple little open spots. That's pretty good. Moving on to the next one. Again, you're holding it almost perpendicular here, trying to get starting that flame on the tip and then kind of wrapping it around. And as that collapses and starts to get really soft, that's when you're going to pull it out and you're going to squeeze it nice and even. Hit the side and the side. Chill your tool. And then the last one. And make sure you get a little heat in the front too, to even out that soak. One tiny little open spot. So now what we're going to do, now that we have our petals, our first three petals established, we're going to move them out of the way. Because we have to get in there and start decorating that pod with the various flower parts that an oriental poppy pod has. So by doing that, you're going to heat the base of the petal from behind, and you're just going to bring them down out of the way. Now we're going to use an encased stringer. It's a Fetre Black that was encased with Rubino. So between, my target point is coming between the two petals, and I'm going to make a little tiny deposit and then rotate and go in between the next ones and the next ones until I have three. And then we're going to come back in and we're going to go right next to those dots that you just put. And these will be the anthers for the poppy. Until you go all the way around, 360 degrees, come back out, and give everything a bath. And make sure you got everything filled in. Now if you want to take a knife or a razor blade or something and you're looking at the line, you can, you know, kind of even it out so it's nice and even. And now we're going to come back and we're going to put a second row on top of that, just above it. And you're just, by the time you get ready to deposit the next bit, you've already pre-warmed that area that's going to receive that next part. So now we've got two rows. And you can look at it from the top, make sure everything's nice and even. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put the stigma, I guess it's called. This is the top bit. If you look in there, there are a lot of them, but because this is so small, we're just going to suggest. So we're going to put six big deposits in the front. So I start by putting three, as I did in the back, between each of the petals. That's a good target point because you can see it. And then you're going to come in and you're going to go in between each of them and put another one. And then if you want, just pull a little point on the end of that stringer. We'll use that in a minute. Now using some narrow tweezers. You're going to come in and you're going to hit only that and squeeze sideways. Skip one and do the next one. Squeeze sideways, pushing forward. Then you may want to come in, preheat everything. It's getting a little cool. And do your last two. And finally, So what you've done is you've narrowed them down, but now we want to elongate them back onto that pod. So heat, come into the really hot part of the flame. Just raise it up just enough. Come above the flame, touch down with your cold point. Tease it down, and then skip one and do the same. And go all the way around. Now you are blowing on it. So you want to come in and you want to preheat everything before you go and do the next three. And you're blowing on it just to get it to release if it's not coming off anyway. And if it's not, you know, if it's not coming to the front all the way, you can go back and kind of tease those up. But these are pretty close. So you look down and make sure that everything is even and the way you want it to be. So now you've spent all this time putting details on the pod. But you've got all of this other, you've got three more petals to build and everything. Well, putting these details, these petals, when I bring them back up, they're going to protect those details. So come into the back, really put some heat in there. A little bit in the front, but mostly in the back. Get it nice and soft, and then slowly start to pick those petals up. It again. It looks messy, but trust me. And you're really flaring those up around that center structure. But you really are, most of the heat is being applied to the base of that petal. And once you've got them in position, now you see when I heat this, this is going to receive some heat when I heat it like this, but this is going to deflect that heat away. It's still receiving heat from those petals, but you've protected it. So it's going to stay nice and crisp. So now we're going to go and we're going to build our back three petals. You're going, your target point is right between the upper two. So you're just making a nice deposit of glass for the base of those back three petals. And you're going to do just what you did in the front. You're going to just get a giant gather, swipe, and start building that mass up on each of those. And then come away and give it a little heat. Now the back petals have to be a little bit larger than the front because they have to come up and around. So we're going to give them a little more volume than we did the front ones. Stop there. So again, up and down. And when that starts to move, you're going to hold it up like that and let gravity pull that out, but push in while you're squeezing. And up, and up, and up. And I'll do the next one. And you just squeeze it and squeeze it and squeeze it until it's nice and thin and even. And then moving it up while it's still soft. Get some heat in the front and the back. And then your last one. Now, the chilling of this tool is kind of important because when you're squeezing that much glass and it's really, really hot, it can stick. You'll feel it starts to get a little sticky. So you want to chill your tool. Now I'm just checking out the volume of the glass, and I can see it's pretty close, but I need just a little bit more on the tips. So I don't want to add any to the base or the rest of those petals. I just want to elongate them. So to do that, we're going to add a little volume to the front of each, but not this way. We're going horizontal. But definitely make sure that you've warmed that area before you put that little stroke down. And just hit the tips now, just that one little area that you've added, and then squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And then heat the entire petal in the back to make sure that everything is nice and fused together. And last one. Okay, now we've got all of our petals. Now we're going to put our little patch on. I have to pick up the right one this time. Nope. So get about halfway up the petal as your touchdown point. And you're making sure that is right in the center so that when you look down from the front, you can see those patches from the front. And now come into the back, and with the flat part of your brass marver, just hit it really, really hard and touch to smooth. But you're definitely fastening that down so that it's not going to retract. And now we're going to smooth. And the importance of smoothing these patches, I mean, you know, if you cased over them, you would be trapping air. So you definitely want to make sure that that's nice and smooth. So we get it a little bit hot there. Squeeze. Nice and smooth. Move on to the next one. Always kind of moving them back into position. Now there's all kinds of things you can do once you've got this idea. You can use canes, you can use, you know, there's all different ways that you can color. I'll add color to the back of these petals to give them dimension and real depth. So now what we're going to do is we're going to put the color, the opaque color, on the back of the petals. But before we do that, we have to think about the strength of the piece. The termination point of those three petals is it's thick, but it's fragile because they're coming down like this, and that's a vulnerable spot. So we're going to take a little of our carrot red, and we're going to run a little wrap around, actually a couple times around. That's going to help strengthen that bead. So we're going to hit it in the back and soften that. And with the flat, right between those petals, you're going to marver up. And then right on any high spots, you're just going to flatten that. Doing it a segment at a time so that the stiffness of these petals is holding everything in position. Nothing is shifting. But you definitely want to make sure you get that nice and smooth. Hit some in the front. You've been away for a while. Check your back. And now we're at a point where we can add color to the petal. So because these petals are so long, we're going to do this in two stages. So little short strokes. We'll do about half the petal, and then we'll come back and finish it off. So while you're filling these in, this would be where you would have a humorous anecdote to fill your time. But I have none at this time, so we're just going to press on. Just nice, short, even strokes all the way around. Always just putting one stroke down. And then adding to the next one and the next one. That helps keep everything nice and evenly warm. So now this is what you've got so far. Now we're going to fill the rest in. is smooth. So come in and just get everything nice and smooth. Just the attachment point. And by rocking it back and forth, you're really not heating, overheating or boiling any of the glass, any, you know, because you're not resting there for any amount of time. But by rocking it like that, you're really getting a nice even heat deposit there. We're just going to fill in the last segments, the color. Always coming back after you do a few strokes and giving the front a little bit of a heat. So I think we've got it pretty well filled in. So now we're going to heat the back just like we did the front. Starting at the top and the sides. And just kind of rotating around. Nice and slow, nice soft heat. We start to come up to temperature, start to move. Hit a little in the front to even out. And soften the front a little bit so that everything moves at the same rate when you squeeze it. And then hit the base of the petal to move that up. And the whole idea when you're building sculptural flowers and things is to keep the petals separate until the very end. By keeping them separate, you've got control over their shape and things, but for the strength of the piece, you want to make sure that when you complete it, that all the petals touch. And I like all the petals to touch in two places, because I think that makes it nice and strong. Ah! Tempting the fates. And of course, that always happens when you're... You don't want it to. It will come away. But you will leave a scar, so we're going to have to go back and fix that. So we'll just put a little camouflage. Yeah, so now you see what happens when your tool gets too hot. It sticks. So last one. So there's your basic form for your poppy. Now what we're going to do is we're going to do what we did in the front. We're going to move the back petals out of the way so that we can further thin and shape and ruffle the front ones for our final shaping. So again, when you want to move something out of the way and you don't want to distort it at all, you're hitting the base of the petal. And just getting it soft enough to move. So now you got three up and three down. You can see where you can make an iris this way. And I'm just pulling these just slightly away from that center pod. I have a tool, like a crimping, I guess it's a crimping tool, I don't know. They call it fish fin plier or something. I had it for a long time, I didn't use it, but it's got two grooves on each side, and it's a very handy way to put creases and texture your petal. So you want to soften one of them, make sure you preheat your tool. And then right in the center, you're going to squeeze, and then you're going to come back in and put some heat back into that. You're going to come back out and squeeze again on the side and come back out and squeeze your last side. And that's going to give you some nice, it's going to thin that petal out even more and make it a little more delicate. So you're going to soften it, and now we're going to recurve. The ruffle is the very last thing. You're gonna texture your petal, and then you're gonna come back and you're gonna ruffle. Ruffling's fun. Everybody likes that. So we're gonna finish this pinching of the front ones and the texturing of the front ones. Always reheat your tool. And always come back and get a little bit of heat in the back and the front, in the middle. And this is also where you can lengthen the petals a little. If they're a little bit, seem to be a little bit short, you can just apply a little bit of heat and just ruffling them or pulling them, lengthening them. And it's kind of a back and forth, so you get a nice even heat application. Come into the back, get a little in the back, get a little in the front of the back petals, in front of those front petals. Now we're going to do the back ones. With any sculptural work, for me anyway, the smallest details come last. So, pupils of the eyes, points of the beak of a bird, ruffles on the edge of a poppy, that all comes last when the piece is actually almost done, because those finest details are going to disappear. So we're going to bring these back up. Again, you're hitting the base of the petal. And if it doesn't move, put a little more heat. Now the reason, you may say, well, why didn't she thin those petals before she put the back ones on? Because now they're really thin and they're very fragile. But by keeping them kind of beefy, you can hit it pretty hard with the heat. They're going to retain their shape. But now that I'm starting to thin them out and and get them a little more delicate. They can't receive that kind of heat without distorting. So it's just a heating and pinching. And then pulling it back up into position. Again, soften the front and the back and the front and the back. Preheat your tool. You don't want to do always between your pinches. You want to come back and reheat and put some heat back in those petals, because this really takes the heat out of them. And if you try to do, you know, any more than a squeeze, you can fracture those petals. So you're starting to work them into their final position as you are thinning them out and texturing them. And you don't need fancy tools. You can do this by just squeezing with a pointed tweezer, but it just is so much faster with that tool, so that's why I use it. Almost done. Now in the back, we have to make our sepals, or our flowers grow in a pod, and then when they bloom and they bust open, the sepals are the green bits that are left in the back. And that also helps, it's convenient that nature did that, because it helps to strengthen the piece of this, of your flowers. So in between the petals, you are now taking your green leaf cane and adding some glass that's going to help the piece structurally. So I start with three, always coming back and reheating the front. This is a kind of a cane that I made that started with white, and then was cased with pea green, and then cased with a darker green, and then finally cased with sage green, and then pulled out. And it's just, it's got so much more dimension than something that's just so flat, like just an encased cane, encased color. You just have so much more different tones in those leaves in the back. So what we want to do now is we're going to heat one of them, and we're going to draw it back, not quite touching the mandrel, but close. And we want to draw these in to just clean that up. And again, you're blowing on it, so it's going to chill the piece. Come back and heat it overall. So I pull them in towards the mandrel to clean that up and make it nice and even. And now at the warm point, we're going to clean up the tips of those leaves, or those sepals. So to do that, we're applying some heat, touching down with a warm tip, coming out of the flame, pulling it out, and touching down with a cold part of that rod, which is going to fasten that point down into the soft glass below, just like that. Get some heat in the front. And you're kind of walking, as you're pulling this out, you've got that string, that little fine thread. You stop it where you want it to stop, and then you just kind of walk the piece over to the flame until it flame cuts, and then you're just fastening it down into the soft glass below with the cold part of the rod. Once you've got it all cleaned up, you know, in the back, that's what it looks like. It's all nice and neat. Now it's time to ruffle. So it's just nice soft heat. It's already very thin and it will move very easily. So it's really just the very tip of the petal you are heating, which is going to allow you to move it fairly easily. You're also moving it back, which is kind of opening the flower up a little bit too. Not hard heat, nice and soft heat. If you I'm going to talk a little bit about if you notice as you're building this and you're getting to the finished stage, if you notice that one is a little bit short, don't heat the tip of the petal. Come down and just soften right below where the base is, and you can really elongate that while not really changing too much of the front. Your textures are still there. Just nice soft heat, and just pull it out. Now we're going to work the front. And we're going to start to move those front petals as I'm ruffling them back towards the back ones. And touching where they can. Okay, now we want to make sure that everything is touching. So in between, you want to bring those lower petals up to touch the upper one. So right underneath the touchdown point, you're going to put some heat and then bring it up to touch, making sure you're splashing a little bit of heat on the front one also. And now everything is all joined. And you're just final shaping now. If you want to pull this one down a little bit more, you know, you just ruffle. And there's your poppy.
Yay!
So does anyone have any questions? I'll talk a little bit about, since we have just a little bit of time. Do we have a little bit of time? I'll just talk about cane layering and the, because I kind of rushed through that a little bit. I just want to make sure that the that you guys understood when I was talking about layered canes. You start with a white core for that leaf cane, and then some pea green, and then I like to use an olive or moss color, opaque, and then double casing with the sage green, and pulling out. And so again, when you're using complicated canes and things, it just adds so much more dimension. And the same with working out how are you going to. What is that color of those anthers on that pod? Well, they're not really black. People use black, but they really are a plum color. So how can you do that? Well, you work it out. You know, you just play around and you experiment. And I found that because ephetrae black is really purple, and then you're just adding a little more of the rubino to it. It really does, when you pull it out, it really does read as plum. So, anyway, that's the show, gang.
Well done.
Thank you very much.
Yay!